Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner, available for code reviews and on-site training. Now, in this episode, I'm going to directly address this question that came from a viewer. So be sure that you check out the list of episode ideas so that you can submit your own request and we can see if they get thumbs up and become an episode in the future. Okay, so the viewer just asked, do we have template type name versus class? And I will give you my arguments for one or the other, and I will show you what I think makes sense, and I'll show you one case where you don't get a choice. So before we continue with this, again, be sure that you check out the video description for links to the code samples and updated information about the channel and swag and all the things that are available, t-shirts, ways to support the channel, and yeah, shameless self-promotion here. But also make sure that you hire me to come out to your company to do on-site training, because we can talk about all these things in person if you're interested in that. Okay, so the viewer was asking template type name versus template class, and it comes down to this. I'm going to write some sort of function and it takes two unknown types, and I'm going to go ahead and fill those in here. And I'm going to point out that I can do type name or class. In this particular context, they mean the exact same thing. Now, my understanding is that it was C++ pre-C++ 98 only allowed class here, and then once C++ 98 was standardized, they allowed type name. And so that's been a long time. That's 25 years ago from the recording of this episode of C++ Weekly. My personal thought is that if I'm reading this code, I expect that the user must provide a class type. Now, class types are unions, class, struct. Those are the three that are class types. And so that would include something like standard string, user-defined types, or whatever. But ints and floats are not class types. And this code is using function template argument deduction, and I can in fact pass an int and a float to this thing. And of course it does nothing. If I change this to type name, then the behavior of this code changes not at all. So to get my specific argument, and this is completely arbitrary, it's just my personal way of reading this code, I think type name makes more sense here. But to clarify, it does not make any difference. Now, there is one case where you are forced to use class instead of type name. This example is for an upcoming episode that I have not recorded yet. And it is the example of a template. So let's be clear. This is a template that requires a template parameter be passed to it. And notice for the innermost template, I'm allowed to use type name. But for the template itself, I must use class here. And that is the only place that I must use class, where otherwise type name would be allowed in a template context. And I guess it makes sense because a template is going to be a class type. So that seems pretty fair. But yeah, that is the only case where you must use class, and I always prefer type name. So hopefully this was an instructional video, not terribly confusing, but it is truly a matter of preference. But since the viewer asked for my opinion, that is my opinion. So I hope that you learned something from this episode of C++ Weekly. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, all the things.